This is the D-Steig D-OfferWatch 32 Supporter Edition. Why Supporter Edition? I will explain that in a minute. Let's go over the hardware first. This is $79 at the time of recording at D-Steig.com. And this design is based on the D-Steig watch Adeline or Adeline. It's pretty much the same thing, except that the screen was changed to a higher resolution 240 by 240 pixel IPS screen. And yeah, what else we have? A SD card slot here on the side. We have a external antenna. We have a bunch of pin headers for connecting, developing your own hardware, whatever you want to connect to it. I already mentioned the screen. We also have a RGB LED and a tiny speaker or buzzer. However, I'm not using that in my firmware right now. We have two USB-C ports on the side, one that is connected to the chip directly and one that is connected through a USB serial adapter. And that is super handy for developing. We also have a reset button that restarts the device. All of this make this a perfect device for developing. But yeah, as I mentioned, this is the D-Offer 32 Supporter Edition. So it actually comes with firmware pre-installed. Let's go over this real quick. You see a bunch of things here that are grayed out. The first thing here we have to do is find Wi-Fi devices. So let's go to scan. And we start scanning for access points. You can see there are a couple more options here. However, not all of them are implemented yet. And yeah, here we are. Those are the scan results. Those are all the networks we found. And you can go through the list here. You can also select one. And then you have a bunch of info here about the network. And then we can select this for a deauthentication attack. It's the deauthor, so of course it can deauth. And here we can start the attack. You can see this little packet graph goes up while it's attacking. And after 10 seconds, it will automatically stop because that's the runtime I set here. Oh, by the way, if you ended up here somehow not knowing what a deauthentication attack is, basically you have these Wi-Fi client devices that are part of a Wi-Fi network, and a attacker can send the authentication packets and the client will see, oh, I have to disconnect from this network and lose connection to the network because the client thinks these packets are coming from the Wi-Fi router that they are connected to. And by continuously sending these packets, whoever you are attacking can no longer access this Wi-Fi network. The difference between this and jamming is that any other Wi-Fi devices are completely unaffected by this. Some devices are also immune to this attack because they implement newer security features. But because you don't know which devices are immune to this attack and which ones aren't, the best thing to figure this out is to test them yourself. And now back to the main topic.
So let's navigate back to the main menu. Oh, we can also delete all of the results if we want to, but let's go back to the main menu. Now you can see access points is no longer grayed out because now we can click here and we are in the same list that we saw before where we have all those networks that we found. Stations is still grayed out because we haven't found any. So we could also go here and search for stations. Let's do that real quick. Okay, we only found one. Now we can go to the stations menu and here we have the one station. Stations are client devices like a smartphone, laptop, whatever is connected to a Wi-Fi network. So here we have some more info about this device and we can also select it for an attack. So that would only attack this one specific device instead of the whole Wi-Fi network, and we can also save it to targets. If I click here and go directly to the authentication attack, then it is automatically saved as a target, but you can also manually add or remove it from the targets list. So if we go back to the main menu, the next one here is actually the targets menu, and here are the two devices that we saved. This is the Wi-Fi network we selected, And this is the client device we selected. And we can also see some more info about it here. And we can also start an attack from here or remove it from the list. However, we can also go back to the main menu and then go to the authentication menu. And now we can select whatever targets we want to attack. We can select either one or all of them. And then if we start, it attacks both devices. So what is the difference between targets and these other two, access points and stations? Access points and stations are what you found from scanning. And targets are devices you want to attack. When you save a device to the targets list, then you can always attack that device. You don't have to scan for it first. Okay, what else? Settings. We have masking SSIDs and MAC addresses here. Having this option on helps anonymize a bit. You can also set a key for it, which is sort of like a password. And we have screen brightness here. So not much else yet. This is the first version. We also have an info page with the version number, some info about the hardware. Oh yeah, I think I have not mentioned it yet, but this is 2.4 gigahertz only. This is based on the ESP32S3, which I believe is currently, at least when I'm recording this, the most feature-rich Wi-Fi chip from Espressif. It has a ton of memory, which is super useful, but it's only 2.4 gigahertz right now. If you want 5 gigahertz, then you just have to wait a bit more. We can also restart from here, from the menu. And yeah, that's pretty much it. This is the DIOFA 32 version 0.1. If you buy this watch, then you will help me with the development. You can think of this as like an early access version. So you can test it, you can play around with it. I will add more features over time and we will get to a more polished version 1.0 eventually with a bunch of features. I have a huge list, but of course my time is limited. My money is limited as well. So if you find this hardware interesting and the firmware as well, I guess, then you can purchase one from D-Stike and this will support me so I can continue working on this firmware. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. I'm sure I will make more videos about this. I've been working on this for quite some time now and there's a lot of stuff coming. So make sure to like, subscribe, follow, whatever, all of the things YouTubers say at the end of a video, and have a good day. Bye bye.